So I'm over here doing a water change on the 375-gallon aquarium. He's due for a water change, and I'm slowly kind of shutting this down, making it an easier transition to move him back to the 2000 and turn this entire system into a saltwater aquarium. For example, today I'm going to be removing the plants, replacing them, putting them somewhere else, and taking out these massive heavy rocks. I'm not trying to do this all in one day. And removing the plants and rocks isn't a big deal. The plants aren't actually doing well in this because I don't really maintain it as well as I should because, well, its main focus is this big guy right here. With that said, I'm going to take these rocks and put them to use. I was just going to toss them outside till I need them again, but I got a good idea. It starts over here. This is my Viejas and Spilla aquarium. Now, you guys know that this is a Central American aquarium or Central American cichlid. I'm seeing a tremendous amount of breeding activity going on in this tank. These guys are colorful, coloring up nicely. I'm seeing this guy is clearly the dominant male. You can see by his nuchal hump as well as his body formation and coloration. And then we got a potential female here, which rivals the size of the male. So I'm not incredibly positive about that. And this is definitely a little girl right here, but I'm not sure which one he's going to pick. What I do know is to trigger them to spawn, I've tried different diets, I've tried different temperatures in the water. Now it's time to kind of change the entire scape of this tank. And what we're going to do is, well, let's start off with the idea that I've had this aquarium all wrong this entire time. And by wrong, I don't necessarily mean completely wrong. Let me change the lighting. Okay, there you go. Not as much reflection. You can see what I see now. Okay, that's better. Not as much reflection. You can kind of see what I see. I hope the colors are the same as what I see as well. Anyways, like I was saying, I've had this aquarium wrong this whole time. This aquarium's all wrong, period. In terms of the scape, you guys know we were down in Mexico recently and I actually swam with some Central American cichlids and I was incredibly inspired. What I saw was a fine sand. There was some gravel or looser stuff, but it was mostly sand. I'm not going to remove this, I don't think. I'm not going to remove this. What I want to try is putting in some smooth rocks with them, taking out this massive rock formation, or sorry, this massive Malaysian bogwood formation, and see what happens next. A lot of the times to get fish to trigger them to spawn is by simply moving their tanks, literally moving them to another tank, or rearranging their tank, temperature fluctuations, or a change in diet, namely something live, like live blackworms, for example, is a great way to condition your fish for spawning. I'm gonna try simply redecorating the tank. Let's see how it goes. First, I gotta take everything out of this tank. I am not looking forward to this because these rocks are really big and really heavy. And I got a bunch of tiny fish in here as well. Hopefully I can get these out. Now that entire Viejo tank is going to change its scape again here shortly. We're going to redecorate it, but that's not for a few weeks. So in the meantime, I was thinking maybe we could do this and see what happens. I'm gonna get this out. Show it to you guys. Just say it's big, it's heavy. Oh man, this video might not happen. I don't know if I want to pick it up and put it in that glass tank. Oh, these ones shouldn't be so bad. Well, these plants are doing a lot better than I thought. Just melting a little bit. Oh, see these rocks here are nice and smooth. It's a river stone. The ones in there are jagged, not as welcoming for a fish to lay eggs on, and that's why we're doing it. Not only to somewhat simulate their environment that they're used to, but to also give them something to breed on or spawn on, lay their eggs on. Okay, healthy amount of water removed. Basically these guys are just getting a really big water change. And go ahead and remove everything from the aquarium besides the substrate. Big difference in the rocks that we're going to be switching out. These are not actually real rocks, even though they look like it. They're from Aqua Decor. Look at that. They're hollow and light. Don't add any weight to your aquarium. And
looking very real.
But I want to try something a little different in this tank, see if we can get these guys to spawn.
Oh, that's a big old piece of wood, isn't it? Yeah. That piece of wood is a masterpiece. Beautiful.
Oh yeah, these guys had plants in here before. They just ate them all. I think we'll grab all back. I think before we do any more rocks, we should probably try to work in a couple of pieces of wood, maybe tangled around these main figure pieces of wood. Not a lot, just a couple of pieces. Maybe just one. We'll see how it works out. Yeah, it's a floater though. Maybe something like that. Something very simple, very basic, mostly open. These are big cichlids, big open swimming space, a couple of hard rocks with visual blocks to kind of break the visual path up from everybody. I think we'll get some pretty interesting behavior out of this tank. Some more rocks here. Whenever you use big rocks, you gotta make sure you put in some small rocks around the base too. I find that just looks far more natural. You don't need a lot, just a few here and there. I like to add three small rocks to every big rock. Odd numbers. A couple big rocks, a couple little rocks. We'll call it a day. Oh, and some wood. Okay, you know what? We're taking the wood out. We're going for a breeding environment as opposed to visually appealing. And the wood, I think, in like this branchy stuff is probably just gonna damage them anyways. All I wanna do is figure out who the male and female is. I know the male, but which female is he gonna pick? And then we'll go from there. So just a couple of big rocks and a bunch of little ones scattered around it. You guys can easily replicate this. I think it looks absolutely beautiful as is. I love these simple scapes. My God, just look at these guys though, right? Tank is like filling up and these guys are just absolutely gorgeous. I can already see some coloration changes. I can already see a tremendous amount of interest in their rock formation. I think we might see some action in a couple weeks. Or heck, we might even see something by tomorrow morning with such a big water change and a big change to their scape. Yeah, I think this is probably the most natural and nature accurate scape in the gallery. A few rocks and that's it. That's really all we've seen, isn't it? In that one spot. Obviously that's not what the entire wildlife is going to look like, but the tank is obviously cloudy just because it's still filling up. But as it's filling, I keep noticing these interesting patterns that are all too familiar. This little one's kind of off on its own, but the two big ones, a little bit of tail slapping, the big guy showing interest in this one. I feel like I should net it and sex it now so I'll know exactly if it's male or female, but I kind of like doing this as well, which is the pleasantly support. Look at them just interacting with the scape already. It's not a huge scape and it's right by the bottom. It's kind of basic and simple, but at the end of the day, I think this is way better for the fish. Gives them way more room within the tank. Tank looks absolutely monstrous now instead of having that big old piece of wood in it. I don't know, guys. What do you think? I guess we'll get a better opinion and thoughts and ideas once it's filled, but these guys are looking good. Real good. Oh, I love it. Let's see. Get this filled up,
see what happens.
So the aquarium is now filled back up. It's still a little bit cloudy from having so much commotion in the tank. That'll clear up probably by the morning. With that said, I think the tank looks absolutely phenomenal as is. Very simple, but guys, these vieja are absolutely going to become tank busters. Just monstrous, bostrous, thick, long, big fish. I mean, I know that as is, it doesn't look the greatest, but I think that we're gonna see some really interesting behavior out of these guys over the next week or two. And I'll make sure that we update you guys either on video or I'll post something to Instagram and let you guys know what's going on. My most curious thoughts here are, who is going to pair up and who isn't. I think, let's number these guys. 1, 2, 3. I think 1 and 3, actually I think 1 and 3 would make the cutest couple. But I also hope that 1 and 2, I hope 2 would be female because these guys are very similar in size, but I have a feeling we got 2 males here and a male female. Let me know what your guys' thoughts are on what do you think is gonna happen in the near future. What are your thoughts on the scape? Obviously it's very, very minimalistic. And within a couple weeks, maybe 3 weeks, this will all potentially change again if they don't breed. But sometimes that's just what you gotta do. Again, let me know what you guys think. I think it looks awesome.